If you're wondering how to get star ratings to show up in Google search results, you've come to the right video. I'm gonna walk you through exactly how you can structure your store in order to get average star ratings to show up in Google and other search results. My name is Jameela and I'm the marketing manager at Fera Product Reviews. And today I am going to be walking you through how you can get star ratings to show up in Google. Now, getting star ratings to show up in Google is really important because it signals that your brand has been trusted by strangers, and people trust reviews from strangers a lot more than they trust what you say about your brand. The other great thing about star ratings is that it improves click-through rate and it gives you a competitive edge above people who are in your space. So when somebody sees that your product has 4 stars or 5 stars and maybe your competitor doesn't have any star ratings, then they're more likely to click through to your product because they feel like they can trust it. Okay, so let's go over the actual tangible benefits of having your reviews show up in the search engine results page. So first, it's going to be reflected on Google Maps. So you know the 3-pack of Google My Business listings when somebody's searching for something like hair store near me, or natural honey near me, then your star ratings will show up along with your listings in Google. The other thing, it's going to help you rank at the top of local search. It's going to boost your authority and trustworthiness. It's going to encourage more reviews, including positive reviews, and it's gonna give your website a better overall e-commerce SEO performance score. Now let's talk about exactly how you can get your product reviews, especially the average rating of your product reviews, to show up in Google. The first thing that you're going to have to do is you're going to have to collect your customer reviews. The next thing you're gonna have to do is you're going to have to display your reviews on your website. Then you're going to have to make sure that it's all schema markup, the proper schema markup. And then you're gonna have to tell Google that these actually exist, that this markup exists and that your products exist so that they can show it on the search results page. Let's talk about step one, collecting customer reviews. So one really important thing to remember here is that the reviews that are gonna show up in the search has to be collected on your website. They can't be third party ratings or reviews. They have to be collected directly from your website. So one way you can do that is you can ask your past customers to leave reviews, but you're definitely gonna need some kind of review management system, and that's where Fera Product Reviews comes in. So if you have an e-commerce store, you can go ahead and you can download Fera for free. You can head over to fera.ai/signup, and I'll leave the link on the screen and in the description. But you can use, you know, any kind of review management system that you want. You can DIY it, but Fera is definitely a simple solution for the majority of e-commerce stores. The reason that you're going to want to use a review management system is because there are a few criteria that need to be in place in order for these to be acceptable reviews for Google. So the first, it has to be attached to a particular product or service. It should also be available on a page in your website. So you can have like an all reviews page, or you can have, again, just product reviews. They have to have genuine reviewer names, and they should not be adult products or services. And again, like I said before, they have to be obtained directly from your site instead of a third party. So you need a way to communicate with your customers, like email or text message, to send out review requests and then get them into your system. So then the question becomes, how do you get your customers to leave a review? So of course, the first thing that you can do is you can ask, especially if you have really happy customers, they're more than happy to leave you a review. The other thing that you can do is you can set up an automated process. So you can set up an ongoing campaign where you incentivize your customers with something like discounts, loyalty points, or cash back. So if you use Fera, you can definitely use Smile, Smile Loyalty Points, smile.io, to give your customers loyalty points. And that's actually a really great way to build community and to get repeat customers. So those are kind of the ways that you can ask and incentivize your customers to leave reviews on your website. I also have a blog post on creating a really great unboxing experience that's on the Fera blog that you can check out. And it will walk you through kind of how to make the experience so wonderful that you don't even have to ask for a review. People are willing to create videos and unboxing videos for you because your packaging and your service is so great. So I'll make sure to leave a link to that in the description below. Great, so now let's talk about step two, displaying reviews on your website. So once you've started to gather a few reviews, you're going to want to make sure that they look really good on your website so that your shoppers can see your reviews. So one way to do that is with an all reviews page. So that's where you aggregate all of your reviews the ones that you've collected, but you want to make sure that it's somewhere that your customers can access so that they feel confident in buying from you. So there are three ways that you can show reviews. So you can do it yourself, you can do it manually, you can code it yourself. If you're really savvy or if you have a development team, that's one route to go. You can also use a plugin if you have like a WordPress site or something like that. Let's say you don't have a specific e-commerce platform that you're using, you can definitely use a plugin. And then the last thing that you can do is you can use a product reviews app like Fera Product Reviews. But if you go to an app store listing on whatever platform you're using, like Shopify, you're gonna be able to see a lot of other review options. So just make sure that you choose the one that's right for your business. I also have some videos on the pros and cons of each product review app and some of the best ones and them versus Fera. So you can definitely check that out too. Here's a little bonus. Whatever you want to do or whatever method you decide to display your reviews, make sure that you stick to a 5-star rating scale. So that's really one thing that Google is looking for. So you don't want to use anything like 10 stars or any weird kind of star system that you want to implement. Make sure that you're using the 5-star system because that's what Google is looking for in order to display your reviews. Now let's talk about step 3, adding aggregate rating schema markup. So you're going to need a little bit of background knowledge on this, but having an app will definitely take care of all of this markup for you. I'll just throw up an example of what schema markup should look like, but I will definitely leave a link for all the documentation that you are going to need to mark up your product reviews if you choose that you want to do it yourself. Perfect. Now let's talk about step 4. You're going to want to tell Google about your business. Now, if you're using a large platform like BigCommerce or Shopify or any of those other type of e-commerce focused stores, they're probably already going to have all of this information for you within your website or within your theme. So that's not something that you're really going to need to look at. But if you're doing it yourself, then you want to make sure that you have all the information that Google needs, like your business name, your address, your contact info. It's best to have all of this information visible on every page, and it's a trust signal for not only your customers, but for Google as well. Perfect, so how do you verify schema markup? So there are two ways that you can do it. The first is through a rich results test, and the second is through Google Search Console. So if you don't have Google Search Console set up, you're going to want to make sure that you get that set up, because you're also going to be able to detect a few other errors that might be on your website and improve your SEO that way. If there's one thing that you can take away from this video, it's to implement Google Search Console and make sure that you're monitoring that regularly. Now let's do some troubleshooting. What should you do if your star ratings are not showing up in Google? So one is that you might not have waited long enough. So it depends on how large your site is, how much authority you have, what your crawl budget for Google is. So it depends. Google might not have crawled your website in the time that that you've added this markup to your product reviews. Make sure that you test your page and check to see if there are any errors in Search Console or any other places that you can test your site. And then make sure that you're not breaking any rules about installing specific reviews markup on more than one page. And then you might have a Google penalty, so make sure that you check Google Search Console to see if any of that is going on. Okay, so to summarize this entire video, make sure that you are following the rules, make sure that you are collecting reviews on your website, you're using the proper schema markup, you've created an all reviews page to display your reviews, and that the reviews are available to users. So I hope that this was a useful video for you. I hope that your star ratings are showing up in Google and that you're getting a really great click-through rate and building trust with your customers and making your business grow. If you have any questions at all, please just let us know. You can head over to fera.ai and download Fera and start using it today for free. Bye.